Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another video episode on ForgottenWeapons.com. Today, we're out here at the range taking a look at a 37mm long Bofors gun. This is an anti-tank gun. It was in the Finnish military. So these guns were originally manufactured by the Bofors company in Sweden, or designed by the Bofors company in Sweden. They were put into prototype phase in 1932, and by 1934 they were fully developed and ready for sale. They were exported to a number of countries, including Finland. They were also manufactured under license by a number of countries. This particular one is in the 37mm long Bofors cartridge. Most of them are in the shorter cartridge. So a few general statistics. This whole assembly weighs about 800 pounds. Has with a well-trained crew a rate of fire of 12 rounds per minute against moving targets, which is pretty impressive. And this thing will penetrate 40 millimeters of hardened armor plate at 300 meters. So it was a light gun. For the Finnish, used in the continuation war and the winter war, they found it was effective against the Russian light tanks, the T-26 and T-28 and the BT. When they started going up against T-34s, this wasn't sufficient. And the Finns didn't have nearly enough of these. When the winter war started, the Finns had one of these guns for every 40 Russian tanks. It's a recoiling action, so the barrel and breech will come back under recoil of the gun. It has an auto eject feature, which can be turned on or off. Right now, the auto eject feature is disabled because the guys who shoot this want to make sure the brass stays in good shape. The loading lever is over here. Operating this lever drops the breech block. You'll see that in action in a minute. There is a protector here so that the gunner sits like this. This prevents him from getting his leg in the way of the recoiling action. They have an optical sight here. Yeah, let's get in and take a look at the controls. We have an optical sight here. Elevation and windage controls on it. Then, down here, this is our elevation adjustment. Turning this crank handle, there's a gear wheel inside. This is our windage. There's another large rack and pinion inside the axle assembly. So this rotates the gun side to side. This guy elevates and depresses the gun. This also acts as our trigger. You hold the front here and pull this lever back towards your hand. That will fire the gun. There's not a whole lot else to it. These are extremely well-designed guns. They're durable, they're very practical. Every detail on it is there for a specific reason. It's not like on a lot of the American artillery pieces where it's simple, not quite to the point of crudity, but very simple. And it's not like the German guns that are just radically over-designed. The Finns just built a really awesome little anti-tank gun. So, turn this over to Bob, who actually owns the gun, and he's gonna fire a round out of it, which is, I think, really awesome. So, let's check it out.
So, I'm gonna go ahead and sight it in, and we're gonna sight it in on a safe that's out there that's painted black and orange.
All right.
We'll load the gun and see what it can do.
Sounds good. That safe is the one with the orange X on it?
Yep.
Cool. So he's working the windage adjustment dial there. A little bit of elevation. Can you show the camera what that shell is? That's the Bofors long. That thing's pretty huge. Cool. That goes in and automatically closes the breech block.
We're still on?
We're still on target.
Ready?
Ready, fire in the hole.
Fire in the hole. Ah.
Oh.
Okay, back up.
So we had a failure to fire.
Ready?
Ready.
Fire in the hole.
That's impressive. Sweet.
Hi. All right.
Damn, that means you have to do it again.
All right, we'll do it again.
All right.
All right, basically we're going to drop the ring on or the block on it. There's a lever on the side which will push your extractors in.
All right, so the extractors hold the action open until you manually push them in. Drop the block.
And then we're squeezing the trigger.
And click.
We're good.
All right. All right, like I said, I'm gonna get some slow motion of this.
You guys think we were just high the last time, right?
Yes.
Alright.
Thanks for watching, guys. Tune in again to ForgottenWeapons.com for some more cool anti-tank guns.